So it's official, guys. I've solidified my favorite series from an anime manga legend this past week. On a list with Ranma, Inuyasha, Mermaid Forest, and any other work, you will find Rumiko Takahashi's Anthology at the pinnacle for me. Truth be told, I'd have a hard time believing that you wouldn't place it in the same position if you sat down and watched this thing. But before I get to the fanboying, let's travel back to the inception. Of course, every Takahashi fan is aware of the Rumic Theatre Seinen manga series, whose first volume dates all the way back to like 87, and ran until, well, it's still sorta running to this day. Not to be confused with Rumic World, which birthed OVAs like Fire Tripper and Marriage to Chojo. This was another collection of episodic short stories. See, what a lot of people don't know or didn't know was that TMS Entertainment adapted a 13-episode anime series titled Rumiko Takahashi's Anthology, which adapted 13 stories from that manga. How do I know that damn near nobody knows about this? Well, prepping for this video, I hopped on YouTube trying to see how many people were already talking about this thing. And to my surprise, this video is the first and only video on this anime as of the upload date. So best believe I'm patting myself on the back. Okay, but let's see what's going on about it on Mao. Surely a bunch of diehard Takahashi fans left reviews on it over there, right? Wrong. Shout out to you though, Snapper-chan. I'm surprised that this anime isn't more popular, seeing as Ranma was able to get 4 more mediocre seasons following the first 3 solid ones. Inuyasha was able to get a whole second TV series after an incomplete 167 episode first one, plus a modern sequel following the offspring of the Inuyasha characters. The most signs of anybody believing Anthology even had some value was Genion Entertainment bringing it to the West in 2005. But it is what it is and we got what we got. But how exactly does this show play out? Well, each episode tosses you into the lives of a completely different round of characters, with a different narrative to what's going on in their lives. I'll give you the first episode as a little bit of a spoiler. Would you believe that this genius of a woman was able to take a simple story such as a no pets policy in an apartment complex, something that any one of us could deal with in our daily lives, and make it into an intense plot for one of these episodes, when one family decides to babysit a penguin for the father's client. As they do their best to maneuver around the nosy neighbor trying her hardest to make sure the anti-pet policy isn't enforced. Another episode I want to talk about is episode 2, and I'll just talk about the beginning. So when this man tells his wife and son he got a bigger management promotion in Hokkaido, they sarcastically mention how happy they are for him and wish him all the best. In other words, we ain't going up there with you. And he sits there staring at them, pretty much mind-boggled as to why. Now, this may seem like a simple story of you shouldn't take your loved ones for granted and blah blah blah, and it definitely is. But this is where I say the writing of Rumiko Takahashi is incomparable. Cause homie hit his head and caught amnesia, and then the story goes in a whole other direction. Okay, so if you've gotten up to this point, I'm gonna share with you the true reason why I feel this show is so deep. Episode 5 of Anthology is one of the darkest episodes I've ever seen in an anime, and I wonder sometimes what mindset Rumiko would have been in that led her to write something like this. I'm not gonna share exactly what it was, but hopefully the clips associated with this can give you some insight. But overall, you need to watch this show, and when you do, look out for episode 5. Jesus. The strongest muscle Anthology flexes to its viewers is the ability to take a minuscule event that a normal person undergoes in the real world and then bring out the best in it in its story form using devices like emotions, interpersonal issues, and simply just being a little extra and dramatic. There's an anime I mentioned in a previous video called Human Crossing that pretty much is the exact same type of show. And it's really good. But unfortunately, it definitely doesn't have the quality of writing that Rumiko Takahashi does, so Anthology definitely beats it out. As a Rumiko fan, which most anime watchers are, there's no real excuse for not seeing Anthology. You got her writing and art style, which some of the designs should be fairly familiar to you, clearly inspired by main characters from her bigger franchises. Also, some above-average animation for the year it came out in, and it can easily be binged at no more than 2 short sittings. Dude, check it out. There's absolutely no reason, after all these years, I have the only video out about it. At the point of this video's upload date, at least. Like the video, comment down below what y'all guys want to see next. I'm out. Thanks for watching. Anime Back When.